Learning to Reflect is a blended learning module for the Semester 1, 2021, Work Portfolio Package at the Australian National University, Computing Tech Launcher Program. In this first of two parts, you will investigate what you need to learn for your project, and long-term for your career. The aim is to prepare you to be a professional in your field, which includes the ability to take responsibility for your future professional development. Learning Goals. In a group project, you are undertaking one or more roles as a team member. This requires technical and professional skills. What skills will you need, which you do not already have? Where will you obtain these skills? Co-curricular programs. Part of being a professional is assessing if you have the skills needed for a job, and going about gaining skills needed. This is commonly called lifelong learning. Development relevant to maintaining and expanding skills in a specific job or discipline is professional development. The European Commission defines lifelong learning as all general education, vocational education and training, non-formal learning and informal learning undertaken throughout life, resulting in an improvement in knowledge, skills and competences. The Australian Computer Society, ACS, uses a narrower range of topics for its Continuing Professional Development, CPD, program. Some examples include formal study short courses, industry conferences, reading industry journals, volunteering, presenting conference papers, and academic research. As well as formal coursework, universities offer a range of co-curricular activities for students. These are in addition to the normal course of study. Some co-curricular activities are offered through ANU Student Experience. Universities also offer programs for students to gain skills as entrepreneurs. ANU sponsors First Wednesday Connect and Innovation ACT. Universities also offer free online courses. The ANU offers courses through the EDX Consortium. Topics include technology management and marketing. ANU Careers suggests using the STAR approach for responding to selection criteria, with situation, task, action, and result. Cockburn, Carver, Shirley, and Davies discuss an expanded STAR-L approach used at Queensland University of Technology, QUT, which adds lessons learnt. You will be asked to apply STAR-L in developing your WPP. Like other universities, the Australian National University lists current job opportunities. Commercial job search sites, such as Seek, have thousands of positions offered. You need to search for positions suited to your experience, qualifications and ambition. For those interested in further study or research, universities list both internal scholarships provided by the institution and those from organisations. The Australian National University has a scholarships for computer science and engineering students. There is the Data 61 Scholarship for analytics, cyber physical systems, software and computational systems and decision sciences. For those interested in setting up a business, startup centres offer programs and grants. The Canberra Innovation Network, which has Australian National University as a founding member, lists programs and grants available to local entrepreneurs, including ANU students. RIBIT from CSIRO matches students to projects. The Australian Government's Job Outlook website lists job titles, tasks and skills. Computing-related jobs include software and applications programmers, describing tasks, job titles, and specializations. Typical computing job requirements are software and applications programmers design, develop, test, maintain and document program code in accordance with user requirements, and system and technical specifications. Typical job tasks are researching, consulting, analyzing, identifying technology limitations and deficiencies in existing systems, testing, debugging, diagnosing and correcting errors. Typical job titles are analyst programmer, developer programmer, software engineer, architect or designer, software tester. The National Academies of Sciences, Engineering, and Medicine distinguish between self-directed or required learning and informal or formal learning. An example of self-directed informal learning is keeping up to date on industry news. Self-directed formal learning would be taking an online course outside of the workplace. An example of required learning in an informal environment would be mentoring by a more experienced colleague. Required development in a formal environment would be participating in annual employment-wide training. These different categories of learning may prove useful in deciding what you need at different times in your career. Please prepare for Workshop 1 and be ready to complete Task 1. Suggested readings are available from ANU Careers and the National Academies of Sciences, Engineering, and Medicine. This presentation contains images that were used under a Creative Commons license. See the accompanying website for a full list of images and attributions.